I drive the Trans-Canada Highway west from Kamloops to Savannah, I'm constantly reminded of the route that the original road took in order to bypass the Savannah Bluffs. My name is Peter Grauer, and I'm in the hills above Savannah. Before the age of dynamite and rock drills, bulldozers and scrapers, the Trans-Canada Highway took a very different route east of Savannah. Today we drive by the vast expanse of Tobiano and often fail to look to our left as we drive west. There, plain on the side of the open hillside, is the remains of the original Trans-Canada Highway. It is also the route of the first road built from Savannah to Kamloops in 1866. Still covered with its layer of asphalt, the traveled portion of the road is only a fraction of the width of the present highway, which is less than a mile below us towards Kamloops Lake. It is worth pondering the toll such a climb would take on horses and mules as they hauled heavy loads by wagon up this original road. The original road bypassed the steep bluffs above the lake. Construction methods available to road building crews in 1866 could not economically or logistically surmount the challenges presented by this barrier. So the climb up into the saddle where Six Mile Lake is now located was the easiest way to get past this formidable obstruction. Here we see the original Trans-Canada Highway swallowed by the waters of dammed Six Mile Lake. The drilling and blasting was undertaken in the early 1950s after the election of the Social Credit government. This ensured that the present Trans-Canada Highway that we travel on today does not have the long hill that early travelers to Kamloops and Savannah would have had to travel.